Well, I think it's a really good initiative on your part to take up a super specialty like fertility. I mean, it's very, very important because quite a large proportion of the population have this problem, and it's a very emotional and social problem now. So I think a lot of focus needs, it needs a lot of focus. There has to be laws. Unfortunately, there have been no laws, there have only been guidelines. So I think it's very important that if you want to practice fertility or any other branch, you have to have some self-regulation and certain protocols in place which you follow and the entire unit follows, so that all of you think the same way and explain things to patients the same way, so that they are very clear in their mind about what they are going through, their expectations and the results that they will get at the end of it. There are a certain bodies which are now coming up, or even the banks, Bajaj Finance and HDFC and different organizations which have now come up giving them AEMI options. So I think this is a really good thing, because a lot of my patients also make use of this facility. They may not be able to put the amount immediately, but when they take the EMI, a lot of them are able to afford this treatment. And I would say, if you, from the percentage, if you look at it, at least 20% of patients who would not have otherwise taken the fertility treatment are now able to do it because of the presence of these EMI options. I think it'll be really nice if the government can fund it. In our country, I think the focus is more on disease, and fertility is not a disease. So it's more on disease, prevention of disease, and treating all the important problems like diabetes, heart disease and cancers. So there is not much priority given to fertility. It would be really nice because it will help the patients, but so far there is no government hospital which has actually brought in. I think only now one or two hospitals are actually bringing in fertility on a free basis, and I think this is a way forward. I think standardization is very important, because you've got to have a roadmap exactly what you're going to do when you receive the patient, why tests are being done, and after the tests are being done, discussion of the results, and following that, if you plan a procedure, why that procedure is being done, all the essentials which are, you know, part of the procedure, and the results that you can expect from it, and after the procedure is done, what sort of fertility treatment you're going to offer to them, and what are the financials involved in that, a very realistic discussion about the results, because many of them think it's a 100% thing, which is not there. And even if you look at an IUI, they think that IUI is the end point. It can give you a 100% result. So to tell them that this is not an end point, it can happen, and you can have many attempts as well. It may never happen with an IUI. You may need to go on to IVF. And with IVF, there is a lot of misconceptions, like what is the impact on the mother? What is the impact on the baby? Will my sperm be changed? Will the egg be changed? You know, like a lot of problems associated with that. And do I need, you know, about working and about their commitments at home, and what sort of, most important of all, is the financial implications and the success or failure associated with the procedure. So you have to standardize all these protocols, so that and there has to be a counselor, because the counselor is the one who's going to tell about all these things, the general things like financial implications and what to expect, what results to expect. The medical part will be done by the doctor, but the other things should be done by a counselor, who should be an integral part of any IVF unit. And finally, what sort of results are you going to expect? And what if this does not work? What is the end point? Do you have to use a donor? And there's a lot of problems with that as well. So you have to be, but one point which people are very, very concerned about is, will my own sperm be used? Will my own egg be used? So a thorough clarification regarding this. And if you are offering a third party, give them clarity on the third party reproduction. We are looking at things which have hitherto, we only discussed clinical aspects. So now we are looking at, you know, the entire scenario and what needs to be discussed in running an IVF clinic. It's not only treating the patient, it's also setting protocols in place and making sure that everything happens the right way, and that all of us follow the rules so that the outcome is good. It's also self-protection, because once you follow the rules, you know that you have something to protect you when you get. We all know that, you know, IVF doesn't give 100% result. So if you follow your protocols, your consent forms are in place and everything has been strictly adhered to, you have all the documentation to say that you have done the right thing and you told the patient that this is not 100%.